Hello and welcome back to Excelsif. Today I have an important video for you regarding privacy of your data. Excel is used for many different tasks, and I believe you will agree with me that most of those use case scenarios are something that you won't just want anyone to get their hands on. So we are going to learn how to protect your data in Excel so it's viewed only by those who are entitled to it and we can keep it away from prying eyes. So let's get to it. I have divided this video into three parts. In part 1, we will see how to protect a sheet both with a password and without. In this method, a user will be able to see your data but won't be able to modify it. In part 2, we will see how to recover or crack the password used to protect your sheet in case you forget it. In part 3, we will protect the entire file so no one can see any contents of your file. Not the data within, not even how many sheets your file has. Here we have a balance sheet you have just finalized and you have to share it with other members of the team, but you don't want anyone to mess it accidentally or otherwise. So in essence, you just want everyone else have viewing rights and not editing rights. Fair enough, it's quite important data and you have spent hours perfecting it. You wouldn't want anyone to meddle with it. So we go to the review tab and in the protect group here, click on protect sheet. You get this dialog box. On the top here, it says password to unprotect sheet. And we have a bunch of options underneath. Let's see what happens if we don't mention a password. So leave everything as is and press OK. Now we can't select any cell, meaning we can't edit anything. Let's close this file and open it again to see if we still have the same status. So we have the file open again and all the cells are still locked. We can't select any. But this is a very flimsy way of doing it. Anyone with knowledge of Excel can go to the review tab and click on unprotect sheet. And since we haven't mentioned any password, that's all he has to do. You see, the moment I pressed it, the sheet is editable. So we should mention a password to avoid such a situation. Let's click on protect sheet again. And this time we will mention a password as 123. Just for the sake of this video, you should never have such simple passwords. Once we press OK, we have to enter the password again, so we enter it again and press OK. Now let's save the file and close it. Open the file again and lo and behold, our data is still protected. If we need to edit it, we need to go to the review tab, protect group and click on unprotect. It will ask for password. The moment we enter the password, this sheet is unprotected again. So what happens if we close our file now while it's unprotected and open it again? Let's check this now. So we close the file and open it again, and our file is fully editable, meaning whether your sheet remains protected or not depends on the state you saved it in. If you saved and closed it while it was unprotected, it will remain in that state, and if you leave it unprotected and save and closed it, it will come back up as unprotected. This is an important bit you need to keep in mind. Also, this method only prohibits editing. Anyone with access to your file can take a screenshot or print the file like this. I don't have a printer attached to my system, but I can very much print it as a PDF. So bear in mind, your data is not away from prying eyes. While we are here, we can also check this option right next to Protect Sheet, Protect Workbook. What it does is, if you choose this option, you can control the ability to change the structure of this file. By structure, I mean the way the sheets are placed, renaming the sheets, etc. Let's check this quickly. So we click on it and it asks for a password. 123 and hit OK. Re-enter the password and now if we right click on any sheet, we can't do much about the sheet. All the options such as insert, rename, delete, move or copy, hide, unhide are grayed out. To enable them again is the same process as before. Click on Protect Workbook, enter the password and all the options are back again. So, you've been basking in the glory of creating such a masterpiece balance sheet for the past couple of weeks and now the auditors want you to unlock it so they can do whatever auditors do. But the problem is, you forgot your password. And now you are in serious trouble. You don't have the time to do the whole thing again and you have to get this sheet unlocked, like right away. So let's do that. Get this sheet unlocked quickly. Remember, We have protected our sheet and the workbook both. So let's try a workaround and get you out of this situation ASAP. Close the file. Go to the folder it's saved in. Make a copy of this file by copy and pasting it. Now we are going to work on the copy and not touch the original, because if we make a mistake, that might corrupt the original file, and then there's no stopping the wrath coming down on us. So we need to check the extension on this file, but there is nothing mentioned. I'm using Windows 11, so we can go to the top here, View, Show, and then choose File Name Extensions. Now we have the extension of our files. It's XLSX. So on our duplicate file, we will change the extension by pressing F2 and then change this .xlsx bit to zip. Just make sure you only remove the xlsx. So now your file will be the name of your duplicate file dot or period zip. Once we press enter, we get a warning that if we change the extension, the file may be unusable. Click on OK. We are working on a copy anyways. Now we need to open this file. You may have a different program on your system to handle zip files. I have WinRAR. If you don't have any program and you rely on Windows to handle your zip files, you may want to check 7-Zip. It's free and open source. When I double click on this file, this is what I have. Depending on whether you are using WinRAR, WinZip or 7-Zip, you will have something similar. Here, we need to go in this folder, XL, and then in Worksheets folder, and here we have two sheets, Sheet 1 and Sheet 2. If you remember, our sheet was renamed to Balance Sheet, and the second sheet was not renamed and it was Sheet 2. But don't worry, we are in the right place. In our case, we only had one sheet which had any data and which was protected. Sheet 2 was blank and had no password whatsoever. But which one is which? We don't know if our sheets were replaced, meaning Sheet 2 was renamed Balance Sheet and brought to the front of the sheets. So just to be sure, we are going to check both. Let's select both these sheets and drag them out of our folder. Now notice two things here. First is the extension, which is XML, and the size of both sheets. Sheet 1 is 10 KB and Sheet 2 is merely 1 KB. If I was a betting man, I would have had my money on Sheet 1. But let's start with Sheet 2, shall we? We need to open these files to check their content, and we will use Notepad for that. Just bring up Notepad and drag this file in it. Don't be overwhelmed with all these lines or quotes. We are just looking for a particular word, protection. So we press Ctrl F to bring up the Find menu and type protection in there. Press Enter and it's not here. Good. Open a new file in Notepad and now we move to Sheet 1. Same process, drag it to Notepad and Ctrl F to get the Find menu and type protection in it. This file has protection in it. Let's maximize our Notepad so we can have a better look. There it is. Now have a close look here. You'll find this less than symbol just before it. You need to select starting from this to this greater than symbol all the way down here. In short, start from the less than symbol and continue till you get your first greater than symbol. Once you have it selected, delete it. Save the file by pressing Ctrl S and close the Notepad. Now we have to put this file in its original location. So we bring up our WinRAR, which is still in the same folder worksheets, and we drag these files in here. In this case, we simply drag the one where we made the changes, which is Sheet 1. Choose your file accordingly. So we drag the updated file in WinRAR, hit OK on this dialog box and close WinRAR. It has served its purpose and quite well, I must say. Now we change the zip extension back to XLSX. So same process, F2, and change it back to XLSX. You'll get the warning again that the file will be unusable. Hit OK and we have our Excel file back. The moment of truth is here. Open the file and let's see. And here we are. The sheet is unlocked and you are able to edit cells. But what about the protection on the sheet structure? Let's check that. That is still there. So a sheet is now open, but we can't move it. No problems. We can still copy it to another file and save our skin, right? Let's do that right away. Copy this whole thing, open a new Excel file and paste it. Done. So now you know how to bypass the password on a sheet. But now that you have this knowledge, you're also worried about your data. If you know about it, surely others do too. Now we need to bring in the big guns. This time, we are going to get everything protected, the whole file. No one without a password will be able to even see how many sheets are there, let alone what's on them. So let's go do that. We go to File, then Info, and up here, click on Protect Workbook. When you click on it, we have multiple options. We have already covered these two, protecting the sheet and protecting workbook structure, and they are not for us. So we are going to choose this option, Encrypt with Password. When we click on it, we get this dialog box. This time, you need to make sure to use a password that's easy for you to remember. Mark my words, I'm not saying an easy password, but something that is easy for you to remember, because if you forget this password, it's game over for this file. We also have a warning from Excel that if you lose this password, it cannot be recovered. We move forward though. We enter a password, press OK, and are asked to enter the password again. Let's do that. Hit OK and done. Now let's close the file. And we are going to open it again and we are asked to enter the password on a gray screen. No sheets, no list of sheets, nothing at all. If we press cancel on it, it goes away. But we are left with this screen. Let's open our file again and enter the password. And now we can access it. So this seems the better option out of all the three we have covered today. Always remember, there will always be someone with the right tools, motivation and patience to get access to your files no matter which option you choose. But as a responsible business owner or employee, we have to use the best options available to us. And this is that option. With this, we come to the end of this video. I hope I was able to bring something new and interesting to you today. If you like this video, press the like and subscribe button and don't forget to share it with other people you might think benefit from it. I'll see you in another video soon. We upload long videos like this when we explain a formula or function every Tuesday and Friday, and quick tips and tricks every day in form of shorts. So keep following us for getting a crash course in Excel. See you in another one. Until then, happy spreadsheeting.